This week on Wheel of Science, we're talking space death or apocalypse wow.
Chuck, there's no end of ways to die in space.
This is why I keep my black behind right here on Earth.
Welcome to Wheel of Science.
Hello, hello, hello. Welcome to Wheel of Science. I'm your host, Chuck Nice. This is the interactive show where we answer your questions about the universe. But I don't answer your questions about the universe. The one, the only, the inimitable Dr. Neil deGrasse Tyson answers your questions about science. What's up, Neil?
I'm doing good, Chuck. Hailing from my office at the American Museum of Natural History right here in New York City.
Do you ever go home? I mean, seriously, do you ever go home?
My home is the universe, so wherever I am, I'm home.
I don't think your family would appreciate that answer. All right, Neil, what time is it?
It's time to play Wheel of Science.
You heard the man. Spin that wheel. Michael Gordon wants to know, will our sun go nova or supernova? Asking for a friend.
You lying. The sun will do neither. Neither. The sun is not that kind of star. The sun, as it gets older and wiser, it will ultimately exhaust the fuel in its core. And one of the things that goes on inside is that it begins sort of converting hydrogen into helium in an outer shell that works its way. It's no longer doing it in the core. It's this shell that works its way out. And while it's doing that, the sun will bloat and get huge, and it will engulf the orbit of Mercury, then Venus. Then it'll render Earth's oceans a boil. They will then evaporate into the atmosphere. Earth's atmosphere will evaporate into space as we lose our orbital stability and descend into the stellar abyss, vaporizing along the way. Have a nice day.
Wow, Neil, you should really write children's books. There you go, Michael. I hope you're happy. You killed us all. All right, Neil, you ready for another question?
Spin that wheel.
Here we go. Dorothy Wiseman wants to know, how big of an asteroid would it take to totally destroy the Earth?
Sometimes when people say destroy Earth, they mean destroy life on Earth. And all that takes is an asteroid 10 miles across. That'll do it. Because you don't have to kill everybody. Well, yeah, you'll kill anybody who is where you hit, all right? They're gone instantly. But then how about everybody else? Well, since we all eat off of one another, if you take out the base of the food chain because you've cloaked the Earth in darkness from this asteroid impact, then that takes out the plants. And if you take out the plants, you take out the animals that eat the plants. Then you take out the animals that eat the animals that eat the plants. And this is a wave of extinction that percolates across the tree of life. 10 miles across would do it. The one that took out the dinosaurs was about the size of Mount Everest, about 6 miles across. If you want to obliterate the entire Earth, there is no such object out there to do so.
Cool. I mean, that's not cool. That's not cool. Will it make a difference where that 10-mile asteroid will hit?
Oh, it won't make any difference at all. We're talking about how much energy is being plunked down onto Earth's surface, and it's an energy calculation at that point. It doesn't matter if it hits land or ocean, doesn't matter. We think if something hits the ocean, the way we normally want to think about it is there's a tsunami and the tsunami's bad. If you're 10 miles across, you are bigger than the depth of most of the world's ocean. So the ocean, it just doesn't even matter. You're making a crater in the bottom of the ocean when you hit. So, no, this doesn't matter. Kiss your ass goodbye.
You know what I love about this episode? It's so uplifting, which is why we're gonna take a break while I contemplate my own death. We'll be right back.
Even after the apocalypse, you'll want to have a website, and you'll want to create that site on Wix. Wix is what I use to make wheelofscience.com. You'll be spending your time running from an asteroid or fending off zombies, so you'll want to conserve your time and energy by using the Wix drag and drop website builder. Upgrade to a premium plan and you can get your own website domain name right away. Go to wix.com/go/StarTalk and begin your site now.
Welcome back to Wheel of Science. What's up, Neil? Are you ready for your next question?
Chuck, spin the wheel.
Nagor Drat wants to know, what's the most realistic way that space could kill us?
Ooh, I like that. Okay, if the sun begins to misbehave, we expect that to happen in about 5 billion years. There will be considerably more solar storms, considerably more and intense radiative particles emanating from the sun. As that happens, it will begin to ablate our atmosphere and basically taking out the highest level layers of the atmosphere systematically. And as it continues to do this, atmospheric pressure will drop. We will have less and less air to breathe as this process continues. And eventually, we'll have no air to breathe at all. And unless we become fish real fast, we get to breathe the remaining air that's dissolved in the ocean, but that'll go away too. All the fishes will die. And when that happens, we all suffocate. That's space killing us in a diabolical way.
And it's space finally making Aquaman the preeminent superhero.
Chuck, you know another way for space to kill us?
What?
So if there's a gamma ray burst that happens a little too close, what'll happen is the high energy radiation hitting Earth will first hit the ozone layer. That's our first line of protection right there. Ozone takes out the X-rays and the ultraviolet. But then there's so much of it, the ozone layer will not have a chance to recover. And so it's just waves and waves of radiation until the entire ozone layer is gone. And the next wave of that high energy radiation then reaches Earth, giving everyone skin cancer. Some people skin cancer sooner than others.
I'm pretty sure I'm in the later category. All right, it's caption time, where we took a picture of you, Neil, and of course, asked for captions.
So can I offer my own caption?
Go ahead.
Back up. I'm about to drop some science on you.
All right, well, let's see how that stacks up against the winner, Elaine Ricklin, who said this: I should not have had 3 tacos for lunch.
I can't argue that one. That's a good one.
Hey, it's time for this week's poll. How would you like the cosmos to kill us? Would it be the expansion of the sun, meteor impact, or gamma radiation? I'm going with gamma radiation because it turned me into the Black Hulk. Yes. Neil, do you have any preferences?
I think about this all the time. If I were to go, rather than getting hit by a bus or dying from cancer or so many other sort of ways to go, I want to be swallowed by a black hole. In fact, let the black hole swallow all of Earth. That would just be, talk about how to use the word awesome correctly. That would be awesome.
Something wrong with you, man. Hey, look at that, we're out of time. As always, we have to say thank you to Neil deGrasse Tyson. Thanks, Neil.
I'm here for you at arm's reach whenever you need me, Chuck.
Kind of sounds like you don't like me. But you know what? I appreciate it anyway, Neil.
As always, I bid you to keep looking up.
We'll see you next time.
Okay, so now you know how space is going to kill you. But we're at least a few years away from that. Why not spend the end of days with a beautiful website you created on Wix? You'll still have time to feed you and your family, so you can use the Wix website builder to manage your business, add an online store, add a blog, and optimize for search engines so all your living humans can find your stuff. It automatically makes you a mobile site, and you can modify it in a mobile editor or personalize it even more.
How cool is that?
Go to wix.com/go/StarTalk and begin your site now. Trust me, even a comedian can do it. And believe me, I did.